It's got some bounce to this. Hey, baby, what you think?
Wow. Ring gang.
Yeah. Ring gang. Far out. Man, it's a bitch. I got an itch to scratch hard. 15 months since my last boxing match card. I miss the interactions and the travel. Even the fuckery that was sometimes unravel. It's driving me insane. I want to get on a plane or a bus. Driving myself a bus to another state like Texas to be engaged in this intriguing fight that's being staged. Hooker versus Ortiz announced I was enticed. Plus the tickets were reasonably priced. Texas has no chill though to keep it real. Negatively, not literally, to tell you the deal. I was like, this shit I can make. Until I heard talks of a no mask mandate. This after power outages and snowstorms. Homes caving in and damages in all forms. Second thoughts, yeah, I'll wait. Watching this at home is just as great. Former champion, a young lion, the story. Trying to find for the welterweight glory. Youth and inexperience is what Hooker's thinking. Ortiz wants a KO that will have Hooker blanking. The winner is looking at a high ranking. The loser, a possible setback from the spanking. A previous scenarios, baby, I laid out. Which will be the one Saturday night to be played out. Woo. Yeah, I know you heard that. So yeah, we got definitely got a crazy welterweight fight between Virgil Ortiz Jr. and the former 140 champion Maurice Mighty Mo Hooker. He's trying to make inroads at welterweight, and this is such a great fight, man. This could be a great TV fight, and on paper it could be a possible fight of the year candidate if both fighters come with their A games. And when I say the A game, it's like both of them are pretty much similar. Ortiz is just more aggressive, not he has power, and Hooker has some underrated power. The biggest difference between them though is the reach advantage that Hooker has. Hooker has a 10-inch reach advantage, and that reach advantage is going to be key to me if Hooker is going to win this fight. He has to keep Ortiz on the outside. He has to be able to punish him when he gets overly aggressive with right hands or left uppercuts. If he can do either of these things and he can keep Ortiz off like that, there's a good chance that Hooker can score the upset or at least get a decision victory. However, he cannot allow Ortiz to get on the inside. And the biggest reason why Hooker's such an underdog is the fact of how he was brutally knocked out by Ramirez, who actually did manage to catch him on the inside, and then he finished him up brutally on the ropes. And Ortiz has that type of power. Ortiz will chop you up to the body. He has bruising power. And although I think Hooker has some good punch resistance, I don't think his chin is all the way there to take brutal shots from Ortiz. And I do think that Ortiz will get in, being that although he's the younger fighter, he's more experienced, has more seasoning at welterweight. So I do think he's going to get in. He's actually going to, and he might actually knock Hooker out. So that is my prediction. I am thinking Ortiz is going to knock out Hooker by round 8. And that was cool.
Snuggles, give me money for avocados.
Baby, when I'm doing my ring gang stuff, it's Pat Scorpio.
Your name is Snuggles, aka Snuggle Monster. We are out of my cranberry juice. Give me money for that too. What? Why are you grunting? I make you food. You should be paying me attention. Stop talking to your silly boxing friends and give me money.
The things I deal with.
I'll tell you who wins. I'll make it easy for you. Root for the black one, as long as he's cute.
Oh, I can't wait to. Let me get up out of here.